Hello everyone, I am Crawlers and this is part 4 and maybe part 5 as I may split this into two videos of my YouTube mini-series on helping new YouTubers, uploaders with, you know, common things like video rendering and recording and commentary creation and just general do's and don'ts on running a YouTube channel, especially a gaming one. So in parts 1, 2, and 3, I covered basic recording apps for desktop and games and rendering techniques for putting out final product. Today I'm going to take a bit of a different path with this video. I'm going to be talking about, I'm not going to be talking about any specific techniques for rendering and editing videos. Instead, I just want to talk in general about networks or MCNs, as they are commonly known, multi-channel networks, and especially as this relates to small channels, be it gaming or otherwise, it doesn't really matter. But by small channels, I mean any channel with generally less than 10,000 subscribers. Now, I say this, it might be a little hard to hear to anyone who's just started off YouTube uploading and thinks, you know, he will become a millionaire in a week, but unfortunately it's the truth. Till you hit about 10,000 subscribers, you are a pretty small channel with, you know, too few views to matter in a sea of gigantor channels and making way too little money to even pay the phone bill. In fact, I'll make a quick sidestep here for a second from the commentary and say something I hope will crush some misconceptions about having a YouTube channel. Not only do you make very little money if you have AdSense or whatever partnership enabled on your channel, if you have fewer than several dozen thousand subscribers, it is also pretty hard and a very finicky business. So views and earnings will vary wildly depending on many factors. Now, writing a script, if that's your thing, recording, editing, rendering, planning, uploading, and creating a thumbnail for your video, takes a huge amount of time. In fact, I spent about 8 to 10 times as much time with everything else I just listed than I do actually gaming. And this isn't limited to gaming channels. I mean, whether you vlog or do comedy or some sort of technical how-to channel, this entire idea still applies. You are also going to make a very tiny amount of money that will vary wildly, as I said, while you are still a relatively small channel. This comes up more often than you think, actually, as people seem to think that once you start uploading to YouTube, the money just starts rolling in by the thousands, and that's literally the easiest scam in the world. Well, it's not. I'm sorry to say it's not, because if it was, then everyone would be at it, and there'd be no people left actually doing their jobs outside the house in the real world. And, you know, the world would grind to a standstill and implode. And even though I'm a very tiny channel, I actually make a ridiculously small amount on my videos. That is, by the way, not set every month. I've already had, by the way, people come up to me and ask me to buy them a game or something like that, or just, you know, send them money. I mean, it's pretty unbelievable, this sheer arrogance that people have, and, you know, thinking that you make thousands of dollars. I mean, it's probably, I probably don't make enough money in one month to even buy myself a single game, but they come up to me thinking, you know, I made hundreds of dollars last month, no doubt, and want me to buy them a game. It's just, you know, too ridiculous to be real. Now, I'd also like to talk a bit about smaller channels wanting to partner up on YouTube in today's climate, and basically why I think it's the wrong thing to do. See, many people make this mistake when they get an offer email from a network. They think, wow, I've made it, you know. Now the cash is gonna start rolling in from all sides, and rush to sign up and get locked in for several years, only to find out that the partnership isn't all it's cracked out to be. I hope to stop some people from throwing away years of their lives with this commentary, hopefully, because I went through these things myself. I admit I didn't know much then, I was a bit naive. You know, there was no one to explain most of this stuff to me back then, a couple of years ago, and although I did ask many questions of my network, there were, of course, things I didn't even know to ask at the time, so I made somewhat of a mistake and signed up, and in retrospect, I was probably taken in with some actually taking an interest in my channel, you know, naively not knowing that it's the standard fishing line that they use on all channels. And as I said, signed up not knowing what I know now, I probably wouldn't have done it again. I'd probably wait, maybe hold out till my channel grew a bit in views, maybe gone with a different network later on, but, you know, that's just my story. Enough about me. Here's what I think of the whole network business. So, in today's climate, should a smaller channel get partnered up? Well, short answer, no. Long answer, get yourself a bag of popcorn and sit back and enjoy the rant. You see, networks on YouTube have popped up a few years ago and started assembling many channels under their umbrella, hence the name multi-channel networks. These networks got paid a lot of money running ads on each of their channels and in turn paid a percentage to the channels under them. They partnered up channels without any copyright strikes, and after you got partnered to these networks, were more or less responsible for any copyright infringements or claims you got on your channel. In return, videos posted by partnered channels didn't get reviewed because the copyright content ID system didn't run on their channels automatically, and these videos were monetized instantly. This led to too much copyrighted content slipping by and monetizing by the channel, although it wasn't theirs, obviously, just because the machine didn't catch it from the start. And the networks didn't give a single shit if, you know, even if it was anything copyrighted, because until it was caught, they were still making money on this channel. Simple as that. In November of last year, YouTube changed its policy somewhat towards MCNs. This came after Fullscreen got sued by the National Music Publisher Association because, as I said, some people let copyrighted content fly in their videos and it got monetized because they were partnered. And no, saying words like "no copyright infringement intended" simply doesn't work. Neither does "I am not the original copyright holder and not the owner of this content." You know, then why the hell are you posting it? Are you uploading it? You know, problems come up, lots of them, and some people do it not out of malice, some people just do it plainly because they don't know better. But as far as the good news goes, this new policy that YouTube instituted last November doesn't seem to affect gamers in any way, because it's the publishers who make their content available or not, and not YouTube or Google. And obviously, those publishers' rules have remained the same. So, networks were made to take responsibility for their channels, and some changes were made. The channels partnered under the big networks were split into two groups: managed and affiliate. Most of the channels automatically fell into the affiliate column. Understandably, this pissed off a lot of people because to be considered a managed channel, your network meant having a ton of subscribers and steady views. Over 10,000 subscribers for some networks. But being managed has its privileges. It's basically everything regarding monetization, how it worked before. Monetizing is instant for managed channels, and their videos don't get reviewed for hours, sometimes days, and the content ID system doesn't automatically run on their videos. Also, any strike or claim a managed channel got would reflect on the network as well as the channel, so networks are made to be vested in their channel strikes that they get them fixed. And this is good news, this, because this creates some open support lines, you know, between you and your network. Affiliate channels, on the other hand, which is like 95% of us, got screwed. Affiliate channel strikes don't reflect on the network, only on the channel itself. Their videos get reviewed and are not monetized until checked by the automatic content ID system, which runs on all their videos automatically. Meaning they can get claimed because a machine matched something to something else automatically. Obviously, the system is a little flawed and claims can be false and people can abuse the system too. You know, sometimes the machine, the content ID system, matches content that you are actually, that falls under fair use clause, or maybe you have the rights to use it because the content creator gave you rights, or maybe just because a company that has claimed that content doesn't have the right to claim it. That happens as well sometimes. On the other hand, managed partners' videos don't have content ID running automatically on their videos. As I said, they can still be claimed, flagged manually, I believe, but the process is then a bit more personal and less likely to be a false positive. Obviously, abuse is still a thing. So, this is a very obvious example of why you shouldn't be joining a network till you can be sure you will become a managed channel because you have a ton of subscribers. Till then, the network is really there just to take half of your money and look pretty. They don't really serve any discernible function. What I'm saying is, small channels stand to gain just about nothing from partnering up with a network today. Today, the only thing a network could provide as a use has pretty much melted away. But they are still trying to get you to sign up all the time, though, as they need someone to feed off. So if they see an up-and-coming channel with a few hundred subscribers, you know, used to be a lot of self-respecting networks required a few thousand subscribers, but now it's all gone. It's all gone to shit. Now networks would rather partner up 100 small channels and start bleeding them dry instead of waiting forever for that one big channel to come along as their cash cow. Soon as they see a channel that's got potential and you can almost see the dollar signs in their eyes light up, they start pestering you with said channel or you with emails and messages trying to get them or you to join the network. Now, understand, these are standard emails and messages already pre-written, and they will be trying to appeal to you specifically, trying to make you feel like they love your channel and what you're doing with it, but in reality, they haven't even seen your videos. The message is mailed by a recruiter, usually, that actually stands to gain monies if he gets you to sign up from his referral. To that end, all the network invites are written absolutely the same and promise the same exact things. Most of them, in fact, are empty promises, which I will try to explain to you here. Custom thumbnails and channel banner, they say, as if that wasn't readily available on its own. I forget what the criteria is, but honestly, you can upload these yourself to videos without any partner network, and they obviously won't make these thumbnails for you. Honestly, it's like paying someone, a company, to make you a free Facebook page that you can make yourself. These thumbnails are easy enough to make in whatever graphics program you use, like Photoshop, for example. They promise to grow your channel. Nope. As soon as you sign up on the dotted line, the networks stop giving a shit about you. They won't do anything to grow your channel, and any growth you experience will be your own, on your own. Sure, some do tweet or post your videos to their Facebook. In fact, all make you subscribe to the Network Hub when you sign up, but no one really gives a flying fuck about these videos, which are basically considered spam. Harsh but true, no one watches what your network posts. 24-hour support. Translation, a few days to a few weeks support. And forget about any kind of support if you're joining any of the Gigantor networks. Access to copyright-free music library. Yes, useful for some, but weigh this against the actual need to use music. Do you actually use music in any of your videos in the past? Do you even need this? And besides, there are places you can get copyrighted free music yourself, Incompetech.com being the obvious choice. And the obvious detail here should be that networks that offer the access to copyright free music library usually have to pay them a lot of money for the use of this music, and thus generally take a much larger percentage of your earnings. Which brings me to my next point. Highest percentage split of any network. Seems like every network has the highest percentage split that they offer you, when in fact it's the ones with the lowest splits that say that generally. You're gonna be stuck giving away 50% of your earnings, or some similar number, for however long you're locked in for, and for what exactly? Now, since I had no one explaining to me or telling me these things, I missed a lot of them and had to find out the hard way on my own. So right now I will go over some of these things which to look out for. One thing to look out for is long-term contracts that lock you in for quite a while. Some networks lock you in, others don't. There are some networks out there with horrible reputations that will lock you in for several long years, and you won't find out how terrible they are until you've signed half your life away. Generally, networks with very low requirements for subscriber and view count are a red flag. That means they are either desperate or just started up, and they will generally try to lock you in for a very long stretch, for a very long contract, because they don't really have many clients and they want to keep the ones they get for a very long time to make money off them. A percentage split is another thing to look out for. Obviously, all networks are different, but it's a business, don't kid yourself. They aren't in it to help your channel grow. One half of the zero you're making right now is still zero if you're a very small channel. So, you know, that's no reason to actually partner up with a network to give half your money away. AdSense. Money that you have, if any, accumulated on your AdSense account will stay there and stop accumulating, and thus coming closer to the withdrawal threshold. I thought as much, but I made it a point to ask my then network head several times in emails if he would be able to help me get my money out of AdSense after I signed on with my network. In retrospect, I was naive. I kind of heard what I wanted to hear, but he said yes on several occasions. Then he stopped being the network head. So you can already see a few red flags right there. Basically, what I'm saying is the AdSense money you have will stay there, and you will not be able to withdraw it after you join the network that you want to join. Which brings me to my next item. Some recruiters are less truthful than others. It's a sad fact, but a recruiter usually stands to gain monies if he refers you to the network, so he will bend the truth or lie outright to you. Another reason for hearing lies is small, no-name networks. Stay away from these. Networks seem to spring up almost overnight nowadays on YouTube. Everyone can just open up a network, take a cut of your money, and start partnering up people. Doesn't mean you have to join them. Reason is, I don't think some of them have their shit together yet. For several reasons. One, they will partner a chihuahua as long as it makes them money. Channels with little views and very little subs. They would rather partner up 1,000 small channels with naive owners through lies, rather than wait for that one moneymaker high-traffic channel. Two, they will literally lie to get you to sign up. Some are that desperate. Three, some are so green that they don't have anything to back up all their crap that they promised, not even a fully functioning site. Hell, I didn't know when I signed up, when I signed on to my network, because their site still had a front page. But after I logged in with my own, you know, YouTube account, I found that there was nothing beneath it. No dashboard, no analytics, no access to a promised music library, no site. You know, this went on for 6 months. 4. Bullshit runaround, smoke, and deflection of any question asked of the so-called support. These are red flags for you to avoid, and as soon as one pops up and your gut feels uneasy, it's time to trust it and walk away. Another red flag that you should keep in mind is when networks tout their high acceptance rate. This is lawyerese for "we are so desperate that we accept everyone that applies." This could mean, well, at best, this means they are a green startup network or a mom-and-pop no-name operation that accepts channels no matter how small they are or how bad the content that they create. At worst, it's a scam. Also, stay away from networks that don't care if you've had a strike on your channel. That's usually a red flag, because no self-respecting network will have anything to do with a channel that abused copyright. Because that stink usually doesn't wash off, and if networks are that desperate to partner a channel, that's a bad sign, as I said before. And before I close out the video right now, as it's been a very long one, I'd like to mention that besides legit invites, there are a lot of different scams being sent in personal messages on YouTube, posing as network invites. Now, one popular scam, and this time a lot more specific one, that has recently popped up on YouTube, is fake network invites, as I said. These are personal messages you receive from the likes of, quote, YouTube Partner Program, which is obviously a fake name because, you know, no one is that general, or whatever other name that you will receive it from, telling you that they like your channel and want to partner you. And please send them personal details like Skype or email or You know, it can even get more malicious right up to PayPal and the like. Now, I'm not saying all personal messages, invites on YouTube are fake, but this is a known scam. Now, how do I know this is a scam? Well, first of all, as I said, the name is just way too general. It doesn't have the name of the company or anything like that. And YouTube doesn't send invites like that. And there are also a few other giveaways. Firstly, the random capitalization or even the general language that the message was written in. If it sounds too childish or just too unbusinesslike, you know, it's a scam. Also, channels are now able to change their name through the Google Plus page. In fact, I recently changed my own name to Making Killing Tactical since 2010. Now, what this means is that any channel that doesn't have the slightest affiliation with a network can change its name and pose as one, sending fake invites to get your Skype username or other personal details that they can later, you know, sell or use them to spam you with junk. One thing these scam artists cannot change is the URL, though. If you click the username to go to their channel, it will likely become instantly obvious if this is actually a legit network. Barring that, to make sure you're actually talking to a company and not a 14-year-old kid having a laugh, always use email and not instant messages to converse. A company's email will be obvious in its address and usually have a signature below it. Also, always ask to link to their website, but you know, as I said before, a website coming soon is a very big red flag. So before taking that big step, have a thorough look through the network's site, research online through forums or the partnered YouTube subreddit. So, get feedback on the network you're thinking of going with. Do not sign up with the first offer that comes your way. Shop around, maybe even wait, especially if you're a small-time, less than 10,000 subscriber channel. Remember, you can apply to several places at once, and nothing is final until you sign on the dotted line. So, review the contract carefully and do not sign it if you don't like it, or try to renegotiate. Okay, this is the end of my rant, so I'm sorry this has been such a long video for you guys to watch, but the bottom line here is go with your gut and don't rush into anything before feeling it out first. And as always, thanks for watching. Please rate and share this video as it helps my channel grow. Check out my other videos at the end of this one. And remember, in Soviet Russia, YouTube subscribes you.